In this video today, we're going to be doing a little review, so we'll be preparing ourselves for what's coming later in algebra. I wanted to review over the difference between natural numbers and whole numbers, and then I want to talk to you a little bit about the number line, and also mathematical symbols, inequalities and equalities. So let's begin with the natural numbers. Natural numbers are nothing but counting numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4. The difference between natural numbers and whole numbers is that whole numbers begin with zero, which normally when we start counting, we don't count with zero. So we start counting with one, which would be the natural numbers. And then you see those whole numbers on the number line here. We'll talk about that further. Now, there are also some mathematical symbols that we need to talk about that happen frequently in math. The first one is the equal sign. An example of that would be 4 is equal to 4. That's a true statement. The one that we don't use too terribly often, but is still a good symbol, is not equal to. An example of this would be 5 is not equal to 2. Those are our equality signs. All right, now let's look at some inequality signs. Let's begin with this one and this one. As we read left to right, you come to the point first. And so this sign says less than. So we'll put less than here. All right. Now let's create a true statement using two numbers that would fit into this. How about 6 is less than 7? And you can see on the number line that 6 is less than 7. And how about on this one, the mouth, as you read left to right, the mouth is coming first. So we're going to say more than on this. So let's use more than. And let's make up a statement that will work in this particular case. I'm going to say that 5 is greater than 2. And you can see on the number line, of course, that 5 is greater than 2. Now let's look at our next set of inequalities. This symbol says less than or equal to. I'll put a little or in there for you. Less than or equal to. If either part is a true statement, then the statement is true. So I will put less than or equal to, and let's make up something that will fit in this sentence. I'm going to say 7 is less than or equal to 10. Well, on the number line, 7 is less than or equal to 10. So that statement is true because it fits the less than. Now let's try the other side. This one, of course, the mouth is open as you read left to right. So let's begin by saying greater than or equal to. So let me put greater than or equal to. I think I will say 10 is greater than or equal to 6. That's a true statement. 10 is equal to or greater than 6 according to the number line. Let me tell you something about the number line, as long as we're dealing with positive numbers here. The number to the right is always bigger. I know we don't think about it like that, but as we get into positive and negative numbers, it's going to become important. Anytime you're checking to see which one is larger, which one is smaller, the number to the right of another number is always larger. Or you can look at it from the other angle. The number to the left is always the smaller number. All right, let's try this one. See if I can fool you on this one. I'm going to say, 10 is greater than or equal to 10. Is that a true statement? Some of you are saying no. A part of it is true. 10 is, it's not greater than 10, but it is equal to 10. So that is a true statement. So far we've used the equalities, the equal and the not equal sign. And then the four important inequalities would be the greater than, less than sign, less than, greater than. And then we have our less than or equal to and our greater than or equal to. Now I'm going to give you some mathematical statements and you're going to decide if they are true statements or not, okay? Okay, using the number line if you need to, I'm going to make this statement. 7 is less than 4. Well, you see that 7 is to the right of 4. So this statement, 7 is less than 4, not true. False. Okay, let's try this one. How about 0 is less than 6? Look where 0 is on the number line and look at 6. You see that 6 is clearly to the right of 0. So 0 is less than 6. True statement. All right. How about this one? How about, I'm going to say 2 is less than or equal to 4. Now look at 2, compare 2 and compare 4. As you look at them, you see that 2 is to the left or 4 is to the right of 2. 2 is less than, it's not equal to, but it is less than 4. So this is a true statement. All right, and let's try this one. I'm going to say 3 is greater than or equal to 7. 3 is greater than or equal to 7. Is any part of that true? 3 is greater than 7? No. 3 is equal to 7? No. So this is a false statement. Alrighty. I think that will pretty much cover whole numbers, natural numbers, and some mathematical equalities and inequalities.